بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. إن شاء الله هنبدأ مع بعض النهاردة الجزء الثاني من Intermediate Accounting Tool. معكم الأستاذ الدكتور زكريا فريد. إن شاء الله تبقى محاضرات موفقة وتقدروا تفهموا منها، ولو في أي حاجة ممكن تبعتوا لي على الإيميل، وإن شاء الله ربنا يوفقكم جميعا ونراكم على خير وفي صحة وسعادة. نبدأ بقى إن شاء الله مع بعض. شابتر 6 بيبدأ بيتكلم على الكونسوليديتد فاينانشال ستيتمنتس اند ديت اوف بزنس كومبينيشن، وده يعتبر امتداد لشابتر 5 اللي كنا بنتكلم فيه على البزنس كومبينيشن. بس الفرق ان في الشابتر 5 كنا شركه بتسيطر على الشركه الثانيه بتشتريها، ففي شركه بتختفي اللي احنا قلنا عليه اللي هو عباره عن الكومبيني، لكن الشركه اللي هو الكومبينور ده هو اللي بيستمر. عشان كده كنا بنعمل 3 entries، كنا بنتكلم على الأول واحد اللي هو عبارة عن الـ amount of consideration اللي كنا بنقول عليها debit investments in company name، وcredit ممكن يبقى cash or common stock وbidding capital excess or bar or bonds payable. والـ second entry كان بيتكلم على direct out of pocket cost، وده اللي احنا كنا بنقول عليها debit investments و debit building capital بالنسبة لي الـ registration و الـ printing بتاع الـ new shares. credit cash طبعا كان في entry الثالث بقى، ده اللي كنا بننقل فيه بقى net assets بتاع الكومبيني للكومبينور، بس طبعا بالفير فاليو، فكنا بنقول debit assets كلها بالقيم الجديدة، وطبعا بيتحمل credit liabilities. وكمان بنضطر ان احنا نقفل الانفستمنتس اكاونت، ويبقى الفرق اللي عندنا لو كان في فرق، يعني لو كان طلع في الديبت بيبقى عباره عن جود ويل، لو طلع الديبت اكتر من الكريدت فبنضطر ان احنا نعمل تخفيض للنون كارنت اسيتس، بحيث ان هو الانتري توازن. دول الثلاثه انتري دايما اللي احنا عارفينهم اللي هو شابتر 5. شابتر 6 بقى ده بيتكلم على علاقه ثانيه خالص، اللي هي العلاقة ما بين الـ parent والـ subsidiary. ده بيتحقق ازاي بقى؟ يقول لك when the investor acquires a controlling interest in the investee, the parent subsidiary relationship establish. controlling interest هنا بمعنى نسبة سيطرة على الشركة الثانية. فالـ investee becomes a subsidiary of the acquiring parent company, الـ investor, but remain a separate legal entity. يعني لازم نعرف ان هما الاثنين بيتنهم مستقلين، كل شركه بتنشر الايه الفاينانشالز بتاعتها عادي، لكن احنا بقى من بنبص على البيرنت كومباني والايه سبسيدري ار اي سنجل ايكونوميك انتيتي، بنبصلهم على ان هما وحده اقتصاديه واحده، وكذلك وحده اكاونتنج انتيتي واحده. فان ريكوجنيشن اوف ذيس فاكت كونسوليديتد فاينانشال ستيتمنت ار ايشو report the financial position and the operating results of a parent company and its subsidiary though they comprise a single accounting entity. يعني كل واحد بيعمل ال financial statement بتاعته سواء من ال parent company او من ال subsidiary، لكن ال parent company علاوه على كده بيجمع ال financial statement for both companies ويعمل بقى اللي بنقول عليها consolidated financial statement. What is the meaning of controlling interest؟ ايه معنى اللي هي عباره عن نسبه السيطره اللي بنتكلم عليها؟ Traditionally an investor direct or indirect ownership of more than 50% of an investee outstanding common stock has been required to evidence the controlling interest underlying parent subsidiary relationship. زي ما احنا عارفين ان بالنسبه للكومن ستوك هم ليهم فور رايتس، اهم رايت اللي عندهم اللي هو عباره عن حق الفوتنج. فلو انت بقى الشركه بقى البيرنت كومباني بتسعى ان هي تحصل على مور ذان 50% من الكومن ستوك بتاع الشركه الثانيه، وبالتالي حقيقي هتبقى الماجورتي، ومعنى ذلك ان هي هتقدر تعمل الليكت للبورد اوف دايركتور، وبالتالي تقدر تسيطر على الشركه الثانيه وتمشيها زي ما هي عايزه. السبسيدري بقى ذات ان از ان ليكويديشن اور ري اورجانيزيشن ان كورت سوبرفايز بانكربسي بروسيد از نوت كنترولد باي اتس بيرنت كومباني. الحاله ديت ما ينفعش ان احنا يبقى فيها العلاقه ما بين البيرنت سبسيدري لان هم في حاله ليكويديشن او في حاله ريورجانيزيشن. كمان لو احنا بنتكلم على فورن سبسيدري ان كانت having severe production or monetary or income tax restrictions برضو may be subject to the authority of the foreign country rather than of the parent company. وبالتالي برضو البيرنت كومباني هيفقد السيطرة على الشركة اللي هي بالوضع ده. احنا بقى بنقسم الشابتر ده الى تو سيكشن في الواقع. السيكشن الاولاني بيتكلم على الكونسوليديشن اوف هولي اون سبسيدري اون ديت اوف بزنس كومبانيشن. هولي اون يعني احنا بنتكلم على ان البيرنت تتملك 100% من الكومن ستوك اوف ذا سبسيدري كومباني. عشان نوضح الكلام ده هنعمل اكزامبل كده. ف consider the following assumption. لو احنا فرضنا on December 31st year 2019 البي كومباني دايما اللي هي البيرنت كومباني دايما احنا نرمز لها بالرمز بي كومباني بليتر يعني company issued 10,000 shares of its $10 bar common stock. The current value is $45 per share. The stockholders of subsidiary company, usually احنا بنرمز لها بالرمز S company, for all the outstanding of $5 bar common stock of S company. في التاريخ ده الشركة طبعا اللي هو البرنت كومباني برضه زي ما احنا خدنا في شابتر 5 صرف اوت اوف باكت كوست اوف بزنس كومبانيشن بيد باي ذا برنت كومباني اون ديسمبر 31 يير 2019 كونسيست اوف ذا فولوينج. هو نفس اللي احنا كنا خدناه في شابتر 5 دايما في اكسبنس اللي هي ريليتد تو ذا اللي احنا قلنا عليها قبل كده الاكونتنج والليجال فيز والفندر فيز ريليتنج تو ذا بزنس كومبانيشن. البرنت كومباني سبند اباوت $50,000. كمان بقى بالنسبة للكوست اسوسييتد وذ ذا اس اي سي ريجستريشن كانت عبارة عن $35,000. طبعا نفس المعالجة اللي احنا كنا عملناها في شابتر 5 هي اللي هنعملها هنا. يبقى التوتال بتاع الاوت اوف باكت كوست عبارة عن بزنس كومبينيشن $85,000. الانتري طبعا هم اللي احنا عملناهم قبل كده نفس الكلام ده. بس لازم نعرف ان الاس كومباني واز تو كونتينيو its corporate existence as a wholly owned subsidiary of the parent corporation. Both constituent companies had a December 31st fiscal year and used the same accounting principles and procedures. ده عشان ما يبقاش في اي مشاكل لما نعمل احنا ال consolidated financial statement ما فيش اي problem في الaccounting. As no adjusting entry was required for either company prior to the combination. الانكم تاكس ريت فور ايتش كومباني واز 40% ان كيس اوف الفاينانشال ستيتمنت بقى اوف ذا برنت كوربريشن والاس كومباني فور ذا يير اند ديسمبر 31 يير 2019 براير تو كونسيوميشن اوف ذا بزنس كومبينيشن وير از فولوز. طبعا ده الانكم ستيتمنت والستيتمنت اوف ريتيرن ارنكس فور بوث كومبانيز عندنا اللي هي البالانس شيت للاثنين. طبعا احنا في الديتو بزنس كومبينيشن بيبقى الاهتمام كله على البالانس شيت لان احنا لسه ما بدأناش اي حاجه، احنا لسه هنبدا من النهارده يعني. فلذلك هتلاقي في الشابتر ده بنركز بس على اللي هي الكونسوليديتد بالانس شيت، لكن ان شاء الله بقى في شابتر 7 هنتكلم بقى على افتر بقى البزنس كومبينيشن هيحصل ايه. طبعا بيقول بقى اون ديسمبر بقى لازم بقى الشركه بقى اللي هي البيرنت كومباني بحكم السيطره على السبسيدري كومباني فقدرت انها تعمل ايفالويشن للاس كومباني. فلذلك اون ديسمبر 31 2019 الكرنت فير فاليوز اوف ذا اس كومباني ايدنتيفايبل اسيتس اند لايبيليتيز وير ذا سيم ات ذير كارينج اماونت اكسبت فور ذا انفنتوريز اند اسيتس and patent they were as follows. فهو هنا جايب لنا بقى الاسيتس اللي هو اتكلم عليها طبعا دي الكرنت فير فاليو هنعمل لها كومبير بقى مع التاني بس. فالإنفنتوري عندنا هنا 135,000، طبعا مختلف عن اللي موجود في الشركة اللي هو عبارة عن 110,000. البلانت أسيتس 365 في الشركة حوالي 300,000. الباتنت ده عبارة عن 25 لكن في الشركة الكارينج فاليو اللي هي تعادل البوك فاليو عندنا 20,000. طبعا مش هنقدرش نعدل احنا في الأرقام بتاع السبسيدري كومباني، ولكن احنا هناخد الفروق اللي هي بين الكارينج اماونت وبين الفير فاليو، بس ديت هتبقى مش في الدفاتر لأن احنا ما نقدرش نغير الأرقام اللي عندهم. فبيقول لي بقى بجزء this was two continuous separate corporation and generally accepted account principles do not sanction write up of assets of a going concern. طالما انها مستمرة ما ينفعش ان احنا نعدل الارقام بتاعتها خالص. لذلك S did not prepare journal entry for the business combination. مش هيعملوا اي حاجة. لان اللي هيعمل الكلام ده بس اللي هي عبارة عن اللي هي ال B company. فال B record بقى the combination at the purchase exactly as we did in chapter 5 on December 31st 2019 with the following journal. الانتري الاولاني طبعا زي ما احنا شايفين اللي هو عبارة عن الانفستمنتس ان اس كومباني، هما كانوا عبارة عن 10,000 شيرز بس بنحسبهم طبعا بال $45 اللي هو عبارة عن الفير فاليو on that date طلع 450,000. بس احنا عندنا البار فاليو $10 هيبقى كريديت كومن ستوك فور 10,000 تايمز 10 difference هيبقى additional building capital. ده بالنسبة لي الـ amount of consideration. أما بالنسبة لي الـ out of pocket cost هيبقى debit investments in this company common stock اللي هي كل حاجة اللي احنا قلنا عليهم الـ legal والـ accounting والـ funder fees. أما الحاجة الخاصة بالـ الـ additional shares فهتتحتاج أو تتخصم من الـ additional building capital ويبقى الاثنين credit cash. طبعا اللي دفع الكلام ده اللي هي عباره عن البيرنت كومباني. طبعا بنقول ان دول نفس التو انتريز اللي احنا عملناهم في شابتر 5، بس ما فيش بقى الانتري الثالث بقى. ليه بقى؟ فبيقول لي الفور جوينج جورنال انتري دو نوت انكلود اني ديبت اور كريدت تو ريكورد الانديفيدوال اسيتس اند لايبيلتيز اوف اس كومباني ان ذا اكونت ريكورد اوف بي كومباني. ليه بقى؟ because S was not liquidated. هما مستمرين as a two separate زي ما مش عارفين اقولها قبل كده. ولكن ايه بقى؟ ال B بقى parent company بحكم السيطرة على ال subsidiary company فلازم ان هي تعمل consolidated balance sheet the only consolidated financial statements on the date. طبعا ما عندناش قلنا ما فيش بقى income statement ولا statement of return earnings. فدلوقتي بقت مسؤولية الشركة البيرنت انها تعمل اللي هي الconsolidated balance sheet، يعني تجمع بقى التو balance sheet، بس مش هينفع نعدل زي ما اتفقنا الأرقام اللي هي موجودة في الاس كومباني. عشان نعمل الكلام ده بقى فالبيرنت كومباني investments account والsubsidiary stockholders هي equity accounts بالظبط عامل شبه ايه بالظبط عندنا زي اللي احنا خدناه في شابتر 4 زي بالظبط لما الهوم اوفيس يفتح حساب الانفستمنتس ان برانش والبرانش يفتح حساب للهوم اوفيس. افتكروا لو جه الهوم اوفيس يعمل بالانس شيت موبايل بالانس شيت ليه وللبرانشز هيحط الرقمين دول؟ طبعا لا، لان ده يعتبر دوبليكيشن وزياده في الكلام ملهاش معنى. فلذلك نفس الكلام احنا هنا، فلما نيجي نعمل بقى الكونسوليديتد بالانس شيت فالبيرنت كومباني انفستمنتس اكونت والسبسيدري ستوك هولدرز ايكوتي دو نوت ابير ان ذا كونسوليديتد بالانس شيت. ليه بقى؟ بيكوز ذي ار اسينشالي ريسيبكال اكونتس، تعتبر حسابات متقابله زيهم بالظبط زي الانفستمنتس ان برانش والهوم اوفيس. فالبيرنت كومباني بقى اسيتس اند لايبيلتي ار ريفليكتد بقى ات كارينج اماونت اند ذا سبسيدري اللي هو الكومبايني assets and liabilities are reflected at the current fair value in the consolidated balance sheet. ازاي بقى هنعمل الكلام ده؟ طبعا الكلام ده هيتم خارج الدفاتر اللي احنا في الدفاتر، خلي بالنا. زي ما هنشوف ان احنا هنعمل بقى هنعمل يعني كاننا هنعمل elimination الستوك هولدرز ايكوتي بتاع سبسيدري قدام بقى الانفستمنتس اللي هو ان اس كومن اللي موجود في دفاتر البرنت كومباني. بس هما الاثنين مش هيبقوا شبه بعض. ليه بقى؟ لان البرنت دفع الانفستمنتس ديت من اشتراها من السوق بالليه بالفير فاليو بتاع الاستوكس اللي هو بتاع الاس كومباني. وطبعا الاستوك هولدرز ايكوت بتاع الاس كومباني موجوده عندهم في البوك فاليو، فلا يمكن يبقوا زي بعض. عشان كده البرنت كومباني بحكم السيطره عملت ريفالويشن للاسيتس بالنسبه للسبسيدري، فطبعا الفير فاليو مختلفه عن البوك فاليو. بياخدوا بقى الفروق دي بقى علشان نحول بقى الايكوتي اللي هي بالنسبه للاس كومباني من البوك فاليو الى الفير فاليو، فبنحط الفروق اللي هو بين الكارينج اماونت وبين الفير فاليو بتاع الاسيت بتاع الاس كومباني. يبقى كده بنقارن بقى فير فاليو فير فاليو، بنقارن الفير فاليو بتاع الانفستمنتس اللي موجوده في الدفاتر البيرنت مع الفير فاليو النت اسيس بالنسبه للاس كومباني. لو طلع بقى في فروق بين الاثنين فدي بقى بتظهر هنا عندنا بقى اللي هي الجود ويل. فالجود ويل از ريكوجنايز تو ذا اكستنت ذا كوست اوف ذا بيرنت انفستمنتس ان 100% اوف ذا سبسيدري او اكستنت كومن ستوك اكسيد ذا كارنت فير فاليو اوف ذا سبسيدري ات ذا نت اسيتس اللي احنا قلنا عليها. بص طبعا تنجبل وان اند تنجبل، قلنا ان احنا لو خدنا الستوك هولدرز ايكوتي بتاع الاس كومباني وزودناها بالديفرنس ديت بالفروق في الاسيتس في النت اسيتس اللي عنده اللي هي بين البوك فاليو وبين الفير فاليو، يبقى انا كده حولت الستوك هولدرز ايكوتي بالنسبه للسبسيدري من البوك فاليو الى الايه الفير فاليو، وبالتالي بقارن فير فاليو بفير فاليو تبقى المقارنه كده سليمه. فلما لو احنا بقى طبقنا الفورجين برنسبل تو ذا بيرنت كوربريشن والاس كومباني في المثال اللي احنا بنتكلم عليه ده البيرنت سبسيدري ريليشن شيب، يبقى الفولوينج اليمينيشن بقى بنعملها في شكل انتري بس عشان نبين التوازن، لكن هي في الواقع ما بيتمش في الدفاتر خالص، ده بيتم خارج الدفاتر. فلكن لما نعملها برضه في شكل انتري بقى افضل. ليه؟ عشان بتبين بالظبط لما نعملها ده يتوازن، يبقى اذا لازم نتوقع ان الكونسوليديتد بالانس شيت هي كمان هتتوازن. فبنعمله ان جنرال جورنال جورنال انتري فورمات الكونسوليديتد بالانس شيت. شكل الاليمينيشن انتري هيبقى عامل كده، هيبقى عباره عن ديبت ستوك اللي هي كومن ستوك في الاس كومباني والاديشنال بيدنج كابيتال والريتين ايرنجز، ده عباره عن نت اسيتس بالايه؟ لما اتفقنا ده بالبوك فاليو. بس لازم احنا نزوده بالدفرنس بقى بتوين الفير فاليو والكارينج فاليو بالنسبه للنت اسيتس عشان نحول النت اسيتس بالبوك فاليو الى الفير فاليو. وقارنها بقى بالانفستمنتس الاس كومن اللي موجود في الدفاتر بتاع البيرنت، هيطلع الفرق بقى عندنا. لو طلع في فرق هنا هيبقى جود ويل. طب لو طلع العكس بقى الديبت اكتر من الكريدت زي ما عملنا بالظبط في شابتر 5، هنروح للديفرنسز ديت اللي هي موجوده في الديبت سايد اللي هي موجوده مع النون كارنت اسيتس ونعمل لها ايه ريديوست. في هذه الحاله الاليمنيشن انتر بالنسبه للاكزامبل اللي احنا بنتكلم عليه هيبقى كده، هيبقى عباره عن ديبت الكومن ستوك وديبت الاديشنال بيلينج كابيتال وديبت الريتين ايرنز، ده زي ما اتفقنا ده البوك فاليو. لو رحنا للبالانس شيت عندهم هنلاقي نفس الكلام، بس الشركه اللي هي البيرنت كمباني دافعه في الانفستمنتس او الكوست بتاعتها كلفتها 500,000. بس قبل بقى ما نعمل المقارنه بنعمل ايه بقى؟ لقينا بقى اللي عندهم الانفنتوري زي ما اتفقنا لقينا كان في ديفرنس الموجود عندهم في البوك فاليو، ما نقدرش نغير القيمه دي اللي هي عباره عن 110، لكن النهارده البيرنت لقت الانفنتوري اللي عندهم يساوي 135، يبقى في ديفرنت 25. يبقى لازم انا كان انا عشان احول الكارينج اماونت اللي هو البوك فاليو بتاع الانفنتوري بتاع السبسيدري كومباني انتو فير فاليو فلازم ازوده بالفرق ده. والبرنت اسيس كان عندهم ب 300 لكن النهارده البرنت لقى ان هو ب 365، عشان كده حطينا الفرق اللي هو عباره عن 65. بالنسبه للباتنت عندهم كان ب 20,000 لكن البرنت لقى ان هو النهارده يساوي 25,000، في ديفرنس عندنا 5,000. لما نيجي بقى نقارن الديبت بالكريدت كده يطلع ان لسه في ديفرنس عندنا اللي هو 15,000 في الديبت سايد، وده يعتبر جود ويل. طبعا دي ظهر بس من عمليه الاليمينيشن لكن دي مش موجوده في الدفاتر اساسا يعني. وبناء على كده هيبقى شكل البالانس شيت بتاعتنا كده. هناخد بقى البالانس شيت بالنسبه للبيرنت كومباني بعد طبعا ما نعدلها بالانتري اللي احنا اتعملت فيه لما كنا بنعمل البيزنس كومبينيشن، وهنزود عليها الارقام بالنسبه للسبسيدري يكمل، وتزود عليه بقى في الاليمينيشن الحاجات دي كلها. هيظهر بقى عندنا في الكونسوليديتد بالانس شيت اللي هي الاسيت اللي هي تعتبر كونسوليديتد اسيت، اللي هي الاسيت بتاع البيرنت مع الاسيت بتاع السبسيدري بس بعد ما عدلناها بالفير فاليو، وكذلك اللايبيليتي. اما بالنسبه للستوك هولدرز فمش هيظهر في الكونسوليديتد بالانس شيت الا بتاع البيرنت فقط. خلي بالنا من كده، ان هو اساسا هو المسيطر، كان هو المالك بالنسبه للايه. فعشان كده بنلاحظ الاتي بقى على الكونسوليديتد. اول حاجه ان الفيرست اماونت in the computation of the consolidated assets liability are the parent company carrying amount. Second amount are the subsidiary current fair value اللي احنا قلنا عليه. من عندنا ال inner company بقى ال account are excluded from the consolidated balance sheet. يعني ايه بقى؟ لو في اي معاملات بينية زي مثلا ال parent company مثلا باع merchandise on accounts لل subsidiary company، فهو يبقى عنده accounts receivable بالنسبه للسبسيدري هتبقى اكونتس بيبل. المفروض لما هم يبقوا شركه واحده مفيش شركه تبيع لنفسها، فده برضه هنعمل له اليمينيشن. بس الكلام ده بكرر مره ثانيه خارج الدفاتر مش في الدفاتر. الكود ويل اللي ظهرت عندنا بقى ان كونسوليديتد بالانس شيت ذا كوست اوف ذا بيرنت كومن انفستمنت ليس ذا كرنت فير فاليو اوف ذا سبسيدري ايدنتيفايبل نت اسيتس. دي ظهرت بقى عندنا لان الكوست بتاع البيرنت هنا از المفروض انها جريتر ذان الكرنت فير فاليو، عشان كده دي تعتبر كده. اللي بيحصل احيانا عشان نعمل احنا الكونسوليديت دي نعمل ايه بقى؟ نعمل ورك بيبر، يعني بنحط التو بالانس شيت بالنسبه للبيرنت كومباني والسبسيدري كومباني، بعدين نحط بقى خانه ليه. احيانا بنعملها بالبلس والماينس، لكن لو انت اتعامل في شكل انتري بتبقى اوضح ليه، علشان تقدر تعرف بالظبط مين اللي بتعمل له اليمينيشن. لما يكون هو ديبت وتعمل له كريدت، او كريدت تعمل له ديبت، فبتبقى افضل لك وتبقى تعمل كده. فالبريبريشن اوف كونسوليديتد بلان شيت اون ذا ديت اوف بزنس كومباينيشن يوجوالي ريكواير ذا يوز اوف اي وركينج بيبر فور كونسوليديتد بلان شيت. The following features of the working paper for the consolidated balance sheet on the date of business combination should be informed. ايه هي بقى؟ أول حاجة إن elimination is not entered in either the parent company or the subsidiary account records. It is only a part of the working paper for preparation of the consolidated balance sheet. الكلام ده خارج الدفاتر، مش في الدفاتر خالص. تاني حاجة عندنا إن الإليمينيشن is used to reflect the differences between the current fair value and the carrying amount of the subsidiary identifiable net assets because the subsidiary did not write up its assets to current fair value on the date of business combination. هم لا، ده هو بيحتفظ بالبوك فاليو لأن هو ممنوع إن هو يعدل في الدفاتر بتاعته. التالت حاجة عندنا الـ elimination column in the working paper for the consolidated balance sheet reflect أحيانا بنعمله بالـ increase والـ decrease rather than الـ debit and credit. بس الأفضل بقى طبعا لو أنت عملته بالـ debit أو credit هيبقى أفضل لكم طبعا، بأثر في العملية. الـ inner column receivable والـ payable برضه are placed on the same line of the working paper for the consolidated balance sheet and are combined to produce a consolidated amount of zero. من ضمن الحاجات ايضا ان احنا عندنا الكونسوليديتد بيدنج كابيتال اماونت ار ذوز اوف ذا بيرنت اونلي. بس عشان كده احنا قلنا عملنا احنا اليمينيشن للسبسيدري بيدنج كابيتال دايما ار اي اولويز ار اليمينيتد ان ذا بروسيس اوف كونسوليديشن. عشان كده قلنا ما بيظهرش في الكونسوليديتد بيرنت شيت الا بتاعت البيرنت فقط. الكونسوليديتد برضه ريتين ايرنينج ذا ديت اوف بزنس كومباينيشن انكلود اونلي بارت اوف ذا ريتين ايرنينج اوف ذا بيرنت كومباني. يعني ما بيظهرش غير كل الستوك هولدرز بتاع البيرنت بس. بس بعد طبعا ما بنعدلها هو عمل ايشو للستوكس عشان يسيطر على الايه الشركه الثانيه. هناخد دلوقتي تمرين كده نقدر نحله مع بعض علشان نعرف بالظبط ايه اللي حصل بجد. ده تمرين طبعا عندنا في الكتاب اللي هو اكسرسايز 62 242. فبيقول لي on March 31st year 2017 Bell Corporation، وده هتلاقوا معظم التمارين يعني بيرمزوا الكوربوريشن اللي بنقام بحرف البي في الاول كده acquire for 8,200,000 cash including out of pocket cost all the outstanding common stock of Starlink company on Starlink balance sheet to net assets of 6,400,000. طبعا لما قال لي هو اون الاوتستاندنج يعني هي هولي اون سبسيدري. البرنت كومباني بحكم ملك السيطره راحت عامله الكرنت فير فاليو اوف ذا اس كومباني اسيتس از فولوز. عندهم البلانت اسيتس الكارينج اماونت 200 مليون لكن النهارده الكرنت فير فاليو ب 11,500,000. الاذر اسيتس ب 1 مليون لكن النهارده ما تساويش الا 700. اللونج تيرم ديت ودي خلي بالنا هتبقى هي دي اللي عندنا مشكلة دايما اللي هي عبارة عن هم عندهم 6 مليون النهارده ما تساويش الا 5,600,000. وزي ما احنا عرفنا في شابتر 5 ان بالنسبة للونج تيرم الفرق بيبقى يا اما ديسكاونت يا اما يبقى بريميوم زي ما هنشوف يعني. يقول لي بقى ان احنا عايزين وركينج بيبر تو كومبليت ذا امونت اوف جود ويل تو بي ديسبلايد ان ذا كونسوليديتد بلان شيت. يعني كالكوليشن نحسب الجود ويل. طبعا هو احسن طريقه عشان انت تعمل الكلام ده كله انك انت ممكن تعمل الاليمينيشن انتري سهله. وعندنا قلنا النت اسيتس عباره عن 6,400,000 هنعدلها بالديفرنس طبعا بالفروق دي ده لان ده بالبوك فاليو هنعدلها بالفروق عشان نوصل للفير فاليو ونقارنها بقى بالفير فاليو اللي هي اللي دفعتها البرنت كومباني عشان تسيطر على الشركه الثانيه. الفرق هيبقى هو طبعا الجودويل اللي عندنا. يعني الحل بتاعنا ممكن يبقى بشكل ده هو ده عباره عن السوليوشن بتاعنا ان احنا عشان نحسب الكومبيتيشن اوف جود ويل ادي عندنا كونسوليديتد بلان شيت الكوست اوف بي كوربريشن الانفستمنتس ان اس كومباني عباره عن 8,200,000 الكرنت فير فاليو هي عباره عن زي ما احنا شايفين 6,400,000 اساسا نت اسيتس بس دي بالبوك فاليو هنزودها بالفروق بقى اللي هي بين الكارينج اماونت وبين الفير فاليو بالنسبه للاسيتس اللي هم الانفنتوري البنت اسيتس وال اذر اسيتس فطلعت الفروق بالمنظر ده. فيبقى بالتالي احنا عندنا طبعا خلي بالكم ان حصل ان عندنا بالنسبه لي في زياده في البلانت لكن في عندنا نقص في الاسيتس اللي عندنا دي فطبعا احنا خدنا بالفرق الفرق هنا يا اما نزود يا اما مش مشكله. اما بالنسبه بقى لللونج تيرم ديت فهي البوك فاليو اللي عندهم اللي هي عباره عن فيس فاليو طلعت الفير فاليو اقل طبعا الفرق دوت كانه هيتحط في الديبت اللي هو هيتضاف على كذا كانه يعتبر ديسكاونت يعني. فطلعت بقى التوتال بتاعنا ده كله يطلع 8 مليون لما قارن ال 8 مليون بال 8,200,000 طلع الديفرنس اللي هو عباره عن الاماونت اوف جود ويل اللي عباره عن 200,000 دي احتظر طبعا في الكونسوليديتد بالانس شيت فقط مش هتظهر في الدفعات الاساسيه. لو خدنا تمرين تاني برضو بيوضح الكلام ده فعندنا ده عباره عن البالانس شيت اوف ذا تو كومبانيز براير تو ذير بزنس كومبانيشن هي عباره عن البيرنت كومباني والاس كومباني. ده عباره عن البالانس شيت طبعا احنا بنتكلم على البالانس شيت بس يعني. ايه اللي حصل بقى في ده؟ الشركه طبعا بالنسبه لل بيرنت كومباني بيقول لي بقى طبعا هنا ان مفيش اي ارقام متعدله الا ان بالنسبه للبلانت اسيس بالنسبه للاس كومباني البوك فاليو بتاعتها هي 700,000 لكن النهارده البيرنت فير فاليو عباره عن 1,500,000 يعني احنا لازم نزودها عشان يبقى قد بعض بالفرق اللي هو عباره عن 800. ايه المطلوب بقى دلوقتي؟ مطلوب مننا ان احنا نعمل prepare a working paper to compute the amount of goodwill be displayed in the consolidated balance sheet on December 31st 2017 if a corporation acquire all the outstanding common stock of this company for number one 2 million cash. 2. B is 1,600,000 cash. طبعا لو احنا بالنسبة للحالة الأولانية عشان نحسب احنا الجود ويل، لو احنا فرضنا ان هي عبارة عن بالتو مليون، فهنعمل بقى ايه؟ قلنا هنقارن طبعا ديت بال current fair value بتاع ال S company net assets، هناخد بقى التوتال بتاع ال stockholders بتاعتهم اللي هي عبارة عن ال common stock وال additional paid-in capital وال return earnings، ونضيف عليهم بقى الفرق في ال fair value بالنسبة لل plant assets، فطلع التوتال بتاعهم 1,700,000، لكن الشركة ال parent company دفعت 2 مليون، يبقى الفرق ده هو ده عبارة عن ال goodwill، تطلع ال goodwill اللي عندنا 300,000. في الحالة الثانية بقى الشركة دفعت الـ parent company عملت investments بس دفعت 1,600,000، لما جينا نحسب الكلام ده بصينا لقينا ان الـ current fair value اللي هي عندنا دي عبارة عن الـ 1,700,000 زي اللي احنا عملناه قبل كده، فمش هيطلع لنا هنا جود ويل، امال هنضطر نعمل ايه بقى؟ هيبقى في عندنا فرق هنا 100، معناه ان طلعت ديبت اكتر من الكريدت، يبقى في هذه الحالة لابد ان احنا نقلل بقى الايه اللي احنا قلنا عليها اللي هي عبارة عن البلانت اسيتس، فلذلك البلانت اسيتس should be reduced by 100,000 عشان نقدر ان احنا الايه نعمل الكونسوليديتد فاينانشال ستيتمنت. يبقى في الحالة الأولى طلع عندنا جود ويل، لكن في الحالة الثانية اضطرينا ان احنا نعمل ريديوس للبلانت اسيتس، وبالتالي الكونسوليديتد بلانت اسيتس هتبقى عبارة عن 5 مليون بالنسبة للبيرنت بلس 1 مليون 400,000 only for the subsidiary، هيبقى التوتال بتاعنا عبارة عن 6,400,000 بالنسبة للحالة الثانية عندنا في هذا التمرين. تمرين تاني بقى برضو عشان بس نأكد كل الكونسبت اللي احنا شرحناها في الفترة اللي فاتت دي، the separate balance sheet of parent company اللي هي parent corporation والS company with their business combination in which be acquired by the all عشان نعرف ان دوت wholly owned of S company outstanding common stock were as follows. بقى تو بالانس شيت كاملين اهوت عندنا قدامنا بالمنظر ده، بس زي ما انتم شايفين اللي ده بعد ما البيرنت كومباني اوريدي عمل انفستمنت في الاس كومباني زي ما انتم شايفين اهوت عباره عن 250,000، طبعا هو دفع 250,000 دول احنا شاريينهم، هو شاريهم من من الماركت بالفير فاليو، لو بصينا احنا للايكوتي الستوك هولدرز ايكوتي بالنسبه للاس كومباني اللي هي عباره عن ال80 بلس ال70 بلس ال50 هتطلع 200، يبقى هو لان ده البوك فاليو، لكن ديت عباره عن الفير فاليو. البرنت كومباني زي ما قلنا احنا بحكم السيطره عليها عملت ايه بقى؟ بصت لقت انها في قول لي بقى اون ماي 31 اللي هو التاريخ اللي هم سيطروا عليهم فيه، الكرنت فير فاليو of S company الانفنتوري والبلانت اسيتس كانت عباره عن 40,000 و180,000 respectively. ال current fair value of its other assets وال liability were equal to their carrying amount. ده هو الفرق بس في الاثنين دول. هو عايز مننا ان احنا نعمل consolidated balance sheet. طبعا احنا في هذه الحاله هنستبعد بقى الانفستمنتس اللي موجوده في الدفاتر بتاع ال current مع الستوك هولدرز ايكوتي اللي موجوده مع السبسيدري، بس بعد ما نعدله الديفرنسز اللي هي بين الكارينج فاليو وبين الايه البوك فاليو، فده كاننا بنعمل الاليمينيشن انتري، هيبقى عامل كده. ادي الكومن ستوك بتاع اس كومباني اديشن بيد كابيتال بتاع اس كومباني والريتين ارنج بارت بتاع اس كومباني، لكن قبل بقى ما نقارنه بالانفستمنتس اللي هي اللي موجود في دفاتر بتاع البيرنت كومن اللي هي 250,000، احنا واخدين الفروق بقى اللي هو الانفنتوري كان فيه فرق 10,000، وبالنسبه للبلانت اسيتس اللي هو طبعا الفرق ما بين البوك فاليو الموجود في الدفاتر بتاع الاس كومباني والفير فاليو اللي وجدتها البلانت كومباني كذلك البلانت اسيتس، كانت النتيجه عندنا ان ظهرت عندنا بقى جود ويل، دي مش هتظهر غير فين بقى؟ في الكونسوليديتد بلانت شيت. بس لو احنا شايفين بالنسبه للبرنت عندهم بقى هم جود ويل جاز من شركات قبل كده شارينها ولا حاجه، فطبعا نضيفهم على بعض، لكن لو ما كانش فيه هنعمل لها سطر لوحده كده وتظهر فيه كونسوليديتد بس بلانت شيت، ويبقى عندنا البلانت شيت بقى بعد ما عملنا احنا اللي هو الاليمينيشن وكده، يبقى عندنا الانفنتوري طبعا دلوقتي بالنسبه للكونسوليديتد، طبعا بالنسبه هناخد بقى بتاع البرنت بلس الفير فاليو بقى اللي هو عباره عن بالنسبه للشركه اللي هي الاس كام من بعد ما عملنا له تعديل، وكذلك الاذر اسيتس زي ادينا التوتال كارنت. بالنسبه للبلانت اسيتس طبعا برضو نفس الشيء، والجود ويل طبعا ظهرت، فبالتالي احنا خدنا الفرق اللي قلنا عليه في الانتر اللي عندنا. وكمان الليابيلتي نفس الشيء اتعدلت، لكن هنلاحظ ان اللي هيظهر بعد كده في الستاك هولدرز ايكويتي اللي هو بتاع مين بس؟ اللي هو بتاع الايه؟ الشركه اللي هي عباره عن البيرنت. تمرين تاني على الاليمينيشن، وزي ما احنا قلنا قبل كده ان احنا بنتكلم على الهولي اون سبسيدري. الهولي اون ميثر ذا فيرست يير 2017 بي كوربوريشن، احنا قلنا بي ستاند فور بيرنت كومباني، اكوير فور 950,000 داش اول ذا اوت ستاندينج كومن ستوك اوف اس كومباني. اند وي هاف اديشنال انفورميشن فور May 31st year 2017 when the stockholders equity for S company prior to the business combination was as follows. They have a common stock of 100,000 and they have additional bidding capital of 200,000 and they have retained earnings of 450,000 and the liabilities for S company at current fair value equal to their carrying amount. The current fair value of S company for inventory, land, and building exceeded the carrying amount by 60,000, 40,000, 60,000 respectively. And they require that we have to prepare a working paper elimination in journal entry format for the consolidated balance sheet for the parent company, the corporation, and subsidiary on May 31st, year 2017. So, to prepare the elimination entry as we explained it before, we have to start with the stockholders' equity for the S company. They have a common stock for 100,000 and they have additional bidding capital for 200,000 and they have retained earnings for 450,000. And the investments in the S company from the current record is 950,000. But there is some differences between the carrying amount and the fair value for the inventory, building, and land. We have 60,000, 40,000, 50,000 respectively. So we have a difference of 50,000, which is the goodwill. That's it. Another problem for wholly owned subsidiary, the separate balance sheet for e-commerce corporation and the S company. On May 31st, year 2017, are as follows. That's the balance sheet for both companies on that day. And we, as we notice, we have the, also the current fair values. It's supposed to be for the S company. When we prepare the elimination entry, of course, we have to take the difference between the earning amount and the current fair value for S company and the elimination entry. But this is in the book. For either parent company or S company. And the requirement, they said also that you have on May 31st be acquired all the 10,000 shares of S company outstanding common stock by paying $300,000 cash for the S company stockholders and $50,000 for the vendor and the legal fees relating to the business combination. And required is to first to have to prepare the journal entry to record the business combination as we did before, and also they need to prepare the working paper for the consolidated balance sheet and the related documentation in journal entry format on May 31st, year 2017. So we have to start entry first for the to record the business combination, which is usual two entries, you know, the first one for the amount of consideration, the second one for the out-of-pocket cost. So it was in cash, so debit investments in its company, credit cash for $300,000, and the investments in its company, credit cash for $50,000 for the out-of-pocket cost. Now, to move to the prepare the consolidated balance sheet, so we have to make this elimination entry first. See, if we look at the this working paper, we took the for both the parent company and the S company, but we have to eliminate the investments in the S company after we recorded against the stockholders' equity of S company. But as we mentioned before, the investments in this company in the current record is based on the fair value. The stockholders' equity in this company, this is their book value. So we have to what? To add the differences between the carrying amount and the fair value for the S assets and also for the liabilities. So we can come up with the net assets of the S company at the fair value. So we can convert them now, and if we have a difference, which will be, as we mentioned before, will be goodwill. But if there is no difference, I mean, if it's okay, and but if the debit side is greater than the credit side, so we have to reduce the non-current assets, which is plant assets in our case, and that we did in that what happened in this problems. Okay. Now, after we prepare this working paper, so we can see the elimination entry in journal entry format as follows. And as we can see, we have to start with the stockholders' equity for the S company, the common stock for $100,000, the additional bidding capital for $40,000. And the return earnings for 180,000. And those, suppose also we made the investments in this company from the current record, which is 350,000. We add, we have to add the differences, as we mentioned in the working paper, between the carrying value and the fair value for the inventory and also for the plant assets and also for the long-term debt. But we found we have a difference in the inventory for 20,000, and we have also difference in the plant assets, and we have also a premium on the long-term debt of 40,000. But when we came up with this elimination entry, we found that we have to reduce the plant assets, so the debit side should equal the credit side. And that's exactly what we did in the previous working paper. And this is supposed to be the last part in the wholly owned subsidiary, which is 100%. Now, we can start with the partially owned subsidiary, which is supposed to be less than 100, but supposed to be more than 50% of the common stock of the subsidiary company. Say, let us take a break now for this previous lecture, and we will start the other one very soon. Thank you. The second part in this chapter is concerned about the consolidation of partially owned subsidiary. Partially owned subsidiary, it means we have less than 100% controlling the interest, but we have more than 50%. That means we have what we call it minority interest or non-controlling interest. This is a term applied to the claim of the stockholders other than the parent company, whether net income or losses in the displayed in the consolidated income statement, and also and the minority interest in the subsidiary net assets is displayed in the consolidated balance sheet. So, because of the complexity caused by the minority interest in the net assets of a partially owned subsidiary and the measurement of goodwill acquired in the business combination, it is advisable to use a working paper for preparation of a consolidated balance sheet for a parent company and its partially owned subsidiary on the date of business combination. The format of the working paper is identical to that used in the preparation of consolidated balance sheet of a parent company with wholly owned subsidiary, which we explained it before. The preparation of elimination for a parent company and a partially owned subsidiary or that for a wholly owned subsidiary. But all we have to do is we have to consider the controlling interest for the parent company over the subsidiary company. First, the inner company accounts are reduced to zero in journal entry format, and then differences between the current fair value and the carrying amount of the company identifiable assets are determined, exactly as we did before. The next step is the use of elimination to reflect the current fair values of identifiable assets of subsidiary on date of business combination. Before we continue, we have to do what? We have to compute the minority interest in the company identifiable net assets and the goodwill acquired by the combiner. And remember, the goodwill here is only for the company. So let us try to solve this exercise to explain the elimination process for the partially owned subsidiary. This is exercise 6-9 on page 246. On February 28th of year 2017, the parent company, which is B Corporation, acquired 88% of the outstanding common stock of ST company. That means if we subtract this 88% from 100%, that means we have 12%, this is the minority interest in this company. And the parent company acquired this 88% for 50,000 cash and 5,000 shares of the parent company for 10 per common stock with a current fair value of 20 a share. The out-of-bucket costs were for vendor and legal fees 15,000, and for the cost of associated with the registration was 10,000. The stockholders' equity for the subsidiary company, which is company in our case, consists of common stock. They have 10,000, and they have additional bidding capital of 30,000, and they have also retained earnings of 60,000. The carrying amount of the three following assets or liabilities were less than the current fair values of this company, which is inventories less than by 20,000, plant assets by 80,000. And the bonds payable was less than by 30,000. And the required for A is to prepare journal entry to record the business combination. And for B, we have to prepare a working paper to compute the following for the consolidated balance sheet of the parent company, corporation, and its subsidiary. One, goodwill, and two, non-controlling interest, which means the minority interest in the net assets of the subsidiary. So first, start with the journal entry to record the business combination. We have two entries as usual. The first one for the amount of consideration, the second for the out-of-pocket cost. So we have to debit investments in his company. This is actually the total of what? Of the cash, plus the common stock, plus the additional bidding capital, which is 50 for each. So the total will be 150. And for the out-of-bucket cost, as we mentioned before, the cost of the founder and the legal fees will be by investments in his company, common stock, but the cost of the registration and everything related to the issue of the new shares of the parent company should be debited for by the additional billing capital, and both will be credited to cash. What about the elimination entry now? We have exactly as we did in the wholly owned subsidiary. We We have to debit for common stock for the S company and the additional bidding capital and also for the retained earnings. And also we have to add the differences between the carrying value and the fair value for the inventory and the plant assets. But here we have, remember, we have a premium on long-term debt, remember that. And we have to credit the investments by the total of 165,000, which is the cost of the investments, as we did in the entry for the business combination. But before we continue, we have to figure how much will be the minority interest. By what? By calculating the net assets of the subsidiary company, which is what? Which is common stock 10,000 plus additional bidding capital 30,000 plus the return earning 60,000 plus the inventory 20,000 plus the plant assets of 80,000 minus the premium of long term debt. If we added all this, subtracted 30,000, so will be the net assets. The fair value for the S company will be 170. And as we mentioned before, the common stock which is acquired by the parent company was 88%. That leaves 12% for the minority interest. So we multiply by the 20%. And we put it as a credit. This is will be in the consolidated balance sheet. So the difference now in the this elimination entry will be debited for goodwill by 15,400. And so this is the answer to the second one. So the goodwill will be 15,400 and the minority interest will be 20,400. Let's move to another exercise. On May 31st, year 2017, the E-Corporation acquired for 760,000 cash, 80% of the outstanding common stock of the S company. What does it mean? It means that minority interest is what? 20%. Very good. And the additional formation for May 31st, year 2017 was, first, the stockholders' equity for S company prior to the combination was as follows. They have a common stock, no bond. No stated value for 300. They have a return earnings for 400,000, and they have a difference between the current fair values and the carrying amount of S company were as follows. The current fair value and its liability equal their carrying amount, except for these three, which is inventory. Their current fair value of 120, but the carrying amount of 80. That means they have a difference of 40. And the land, its carrying amount in the book of the S company was 250, but now its current fair value is 300, which means difference of 50. And the building, its carrying amount is 740, but its current value, fair value right now is 800, which means we have 60,000 as a difference. And the required is to prepare a working paper elimination and journal entry format for the consolidated balance sheet for the B Corporation and its subsidiary on May 31st, year 2017. So all we have to do is what? We have to also, as we mentioned before, to start with the stockholders' equity of the S company, which is common stock 300,000 and earnings of 400. And we have these differences to what? To change the net assets from the carrying or the book value to fair value. So we have to debit inventory by 40 and the land by 50 and the building will be 60. But we have to credit the investments by 760. But before we continue, we have to do what? We have to calculate how much will be the minority interest. The minority interest will be what? Will be the net assets of the S company at their value times the ratios, their interest, which is 20%, as we mentioned before. That gives us the goodwill of 80,000, and that will be the elimination entry when we prepare the consolidated balance sheet between the parent company and the S company, of course. Another exercise on the partially owned subsidiary, the working paper elimination in journal entry format on August 31st year 2017 for the consolidated balance sheet of the Balloon Corporation and subsidiary is shown below. As now they started with the elimination entry as we did before. So we have the stockholders' equity of the subsidiary. And also we have inventories, which is the difference between the fair value and the carrying value, and also for the plant assets and also for the patent. And they have a minority interest, which is non-controlling interest. That means they have a partially owned subsidiary. And they have a goodwill here for the parent company. Required is to do what percentage of the outstanding common of the subsidiary was acquired by the parent company? What was the aggregate current fair value of S company identifiable net assets on August 31st, year 2017? And what amount would be assigned to goodwill under the method that infers the total current fair value for the S total net assets based on the parent company investments, and what amount be assigned to the non-controlling interest, which is the minority interest in the net assets of the subsidiary under C. To answer the first one, which is the percentage of the outstanding common, we have to remember that in the previous exercises, we mentioned that the parent acquire as a percentage which is less than 100% but more than 50%. And we subtract it from 100% so we can come up with the minority interest in this subsidiary. Now we have to do it in the reverse order. By what? So we can calculate the percentage of the minority interest first, and we subtract it from 100 so we can keep up with the percentage for the parent company. How we can do that? All we have to do what? Is to divide it, the non-controlling interest, which is the minority interest, which is 21,870 in our case, by what? By the net assets of the S company at the fair value, which is the debit side except for the goodwill. So if we divide it, this 21,870 by the total of the debit without the goodwill, that gives you the percentage of the minority interest. So if we subtract it from 100, that gives you the percentage of the outstanding common stock was acquired by the parent company. And we can see that in the next slides. See? So the first one, controlling interest will be 100% minus the minority interest over the net asset of the S company at fair values. And we came up with 21,800 divided by the total, which is 182,250. That gives you 20% subtracted from 100. So the controlling interest of the parent company is 88%. So answer number B, what is the aggregate current fair value of the based on the which means what it will be the current fair value based on the amount of the investment in the parent company. If the net assets is 182,250, this is the net assets by what? By the fair value of the S company. But what amount should be assigned to the goodwill under the method that if we infer the total current fair value of the S company based on the price of the parent company investments. If the price, if the investment is represent 88%, so how much will be the fair value of the net assets of the subsidiary company based on this amount which is paid by the parent company. We have to do what? We have to divide it, the investments by 88%, so we can keep up with 188,250. This is the amount of the whole subsidiary net assets based on the price paid by the parent company. Based on this value, so the goodwill will be actually 6,000 in this case. But this is for the whole company based on the price of the parent company. And how much will be the minority interest if we multiply the net assets by the 12%? So we came up with this is supposed to be the minority interest for this company. Another exercise, this is problem this time. On October 31st, year 2017, the parent corporation acquired 83%, which means what? Which means we have 17% for the minority interest. 83% of the outstanding common stock of this company for 50,000 shares of P, which is, it has no bar, but we have, they have a stated value of 2. The current fair value for their share is 10 common stock, and the out-of-pocket costs were as follows: legal and vendor fees was 34,750, and they have a cost associated with the SEC registration, which is 55,150, and there were no intercompany transaction between the constituent companies prior to the business. And there is a separate balance sheet for P Corporation and the S Company prior to the business company were as follows. And that's a balance sheet. And as we mentioned before, this chapter is also on the date of business combination, which is considered only on the consolidated balance sheet. And also we have the current fair value for the S Company. For their inventory and for their plant assets and also for their patent and also for the long-term debt. The requirement for this problem is to prepare first a journal entry to record the business combination and also to prepare the working paper elimination in journal entry format and the related working paper also for the consolidated condition. Entry for the business combination, which is a normal two entries. First, direct investments in this company for 50,000 times 10, which is a fair value for the shares of the parent company, but credit the common stock at 2, which is the stated value, and the difference will be the additional bidding capital. And also for the out-of-pocket cost, we debit investment for 34,750, we have to debit additional bidding capital for 55,150. So credit cash for 97. And remember, of course, this increase will affect the balance sheet for the parent company. And they have to change. The common stock will change, the additional bidding capital will change, the cash will change, and so on. And the working paper elimination in journal format will be common stock for the S company for 100,000, return earnings for 336,000, the inventory, which is the difference between the carrying amount and the fair value for the inventory for 20, plant assets for 50, and the patent for 15. But we have a long-term debt, it was the present value was less by 15,000. And we have to take the credit investments by 534,750. And of course, we have to calculate first, before we continue to compute the goodwill, we have to calculate first for the minority interest, which is the net assets, as we mentioned before, times 17%, which is the difference between 100 and 83%. So we can keep up with goodwill of 89,800. And this was the end of chapter 6, which is the consolidated financial statement on the date of business combination. But we concentrate only here on the balance sheet. But what will happen after that? And that will be in chapter 7, which is related to the consolidated financial statement after, in the date subsequent to the date of business combination. Let us have a break first, then we can continue for chapter 7. Thank you. لازم إن شاء الله نبدأ شابتر 7 بقى على بركة الله. Consolidated financial statement subsequent to date of business combination. إيه بقى اللي هيحصل بعد عملية business combination في أول سنة بقى؟ برضو هنفرق الشابتر ده إلى قسمين. أول واحد هيتكلم على الـ wholly owned subsidiaries، والتاني هيتكلم على الـ partially owned subsidiaries. ايه هي بقى الاوبريتنج ريزلتس اللي ممكن تاثر على البيرنت كومباني بعد بقى ما هو سيطر على السبسيدري كومباني؟ فبيقول لي بقى الاكونتنج فور اوبريتنج ريزلتس اوف كونسوليديتد سبسيدري، البيرنت كومباني ماي تشوز ايذر اوف ذا تو ميثودز، طريقتين، يا اما الايكويتي ميثودز اوف اكونتنج يا اما الكوست ميثودز اوف اكونتنج. بس الموست كومن طبعا هي الايكويتي ميثود، اللي احنا ان شاء الله هنركز عليها في الشابتر ده. الايكويتي ميثود معناها ان الانفستمنت ان اس كومباني اكونت از تشينج باي ثلاث حاجات، 3 things. First, share of dividends declared by the subsidiary. Every time the subsidiary يعمل declare the dividends لازم البيرنت يثبت حقه فيها. طبعا إذا كان هولي أولد يبقى 100%، إذا كان بارشلي أولد هياخد على قد النسبة بتاعته بس. تاني حاجة عندنا اللي هو البيرنت كومباني كونايز إتس شير أوف ذا سبسيدري نت إنكم أور نت لوس. أول ما السبسيدري يعلن الإنكم ستيتمنت هيبقى النت إنكم أو النت لوس، هيبقى البيرنت هيبقى ليه النسبة بتاعته. لو كان هولي أولد هياخد 100%، لو كان بارشلي أولد هياخد برضه النسبة بتاعته. الجزء التالت بقى اللي هو عبارة عن إيه بقى؟ الفروق اللي كانت ما بين الـ carrying amount والـ fair value في الـ assets أو النت assets بتاع الـ subsidiary، ده هنعمل فيها إيه؟ مش هتستمر كده forever يعني، فلابد إن إحنا نعمل إيه؟ كان المفروض الـ subsidiary كان يعدل الأرقام بتاعته، وبالتالي هتأثر على النتيجة بتاعته من net income أو net loss، لكن هو المفروض مش هيعمل كده، فأصبحت دي مسؤولية الـ parent هو اللي يعملها. فبالتالي يجب على البيرنت يعمل ايه بقى؟ يعمل adjust for depreciation and amortization of the differences between the current fair values and the carrying amount of the subsidiary identifiable net assets on the date of business combination. يبقى معنى ذلك ان النت انكم اللي هو جاي لنا من عند السبسيدري ده يعتبر كانه اوفر ستيتد، او اذا كان لوست يعتبر اندر ستيتد. فلازم احنا نعدلها بقى بالdepreciation والamortization بتاع differences اللي هي ما بين الفير فاليو وبين الكارينج اماونت بتاع النت اسيتس بتاع السبسيدري اون ذا ديت اوف بزنس ايه كومبانيشن. يبقى دول تقريبا الثلاثه انت اللي هيعملهم الايه؟ البيرنت كومن. طبعا الجزء الثالث ده هيتعمل لحد ما يتخلص من الفروق، خلاص مش هيعملها تاني، مجرد الفتره بتاعتها دي. فلذلك اول حاجه عشان نعمل ريكورد للبيرنت شير اوف ديفيدنس ديكلير باي ذا سبسيدري، الانتري بتاعنا خلي بالكم هو لما يعمل ديكلاريشن هيبقى البيرنت يقول يبقى ديبت انر كومباني ديفيدند ريسيفبل كريديت انفستمنتس ان اس كومباني كومن ستوك. يبقى معنى ذلك الديفيدندز اللي بيعلنها السبسيدري بتقلل الانفستمنتس عند البيرنت، كانه بيعمل ريفاند بالظبط. اما بالنسبه للسبسيدري هيقول يبقى هيبقى بالنسبه له ديفيدند ديكليرز دي تعتبر طبعا كاش ديفيدندز credit inner company dividends payable، هو هيدفع دي والبيرنت طبعا هيحصل الكلام ده، ولما يحصل الكلام ده كانه بيسترد الانفستمنت بتاعته، عشان كده بتعتبر كانها بيعمل ريفاند. اما بالنسبه بقى للنت انكم او النت لوس بالنسبه للسبسيدري، فالبيرنت بقى كومباني should recognize its share of the subsidiary net income or net loss as follows. النت انكم هيعمل ايه؟ هيزود الانفستمنت بتاع البيرنت، والنت لوس هيقلل الانفستمنت بتاع البيرنت. فلذلك لو ان كيس اوف سبسيدر نت انكم البيرنت هيقول ايه بقى؟ جريت انفستمنت ان ذيس كومباني كومن ستوك كريدت ان ار كومباني انفستمنت انكم. وان كيس اوف نت لوس هيقول جريت ان ار كومباني انفستمنت انكم كريدت انفستمنت ان ذيس كومباني. برضه هيقول ديبت ان كومن انفستمنت انكم ليه؟ علشان لو كان عنده كذا شركه يبقى في الاخر ياخد النتيجه النهائيه بتاعته، عشان كده بيقول عليه انكم برضه. بالاضافه بقى الاديشن تو ذا تو فور جوينج جورنال انتري اللي هو واحد بالديفيدنس والثاني بالنسبه للنت انكم والنت لوس، البيرم ماست بريبير ان ادجستنج بقى جورنال انتري. احنا قلنا ليه؟ ان النت انكم اللي جاي لنا من عند السبسيدري ممكن يكون اوفر ستيتد، او لو كان لوس كان هيبقى اندر ستيتد، فلازم البيرنت يعدل الرقم ده بقى on December 31st to adjust the subsidiary net income for depreciation and amortization. لمين ده بقى؟ attributable for the differences between the current fair value and carrying amount of the subsidiary identified with net assets on the date of business combination. Because such differences were not recorded by the subsidiary, لأن المفروض هو مش هيعمل كده. So the subsidiary net income is overstated from the point of view of the consolidated entity. طب الانتر اللي هيعمله ايه بقى هنا؟ طبعا لو كان هو نت انكم هيعكس البيرنت، هيعكس الانتر اللي كان عامله قبل كده، ولو كان نسله هيزودها طبعا. فهيبقى الانتر بتاعه هيكون بقى ديبت انر كومباني انفستمنتس انكم كريدت ان انفستمنتس ان اس اي كومباني كومن ستوك. علشان نوضح الفكرة، فـ let's solve this exercise. On September 30th, year 2016, date of combination, the current fair value differences of the net assets of the spare company, which is the subsidiary company, which is wholly owned subsidiary of the Benz Corporation, and this is of course the parent company, were as shown below. In addition, they have a goodwill of 45,000 was recognized in the spare business combination and the elimination entry, of course, when they prepared the consolidated balance sheet at the date of business combination. And these are the assets which their fair value different than their carrying amount. They have inventory of 100,000 carrying amount, but the fair value which was 120, and the difference is 20. And they mentioned here the FIFO. What do you mean by that? In this inventory, it should be first in, first out, will be sold first, which means will be sold in the first year, but will not be shown as after that. And they have a plant assets which is depreciable over 10 year life. So the difference, which is 120,000 between the carrying amount, which is 560, and the current fair value, which is 680, supposed to be depreciated on 10 years, which means the depreciation will be every year 12. After 10 years, will be this difference will be zero. And also for the identifiable intangible assets, they have a difference of 40,000. They mentioned here it will be amortizable over 5 years life. That means this 40,000 should be divided by 5, which means it will be 8,000 every year for 5 years. So after 5 years, this difference will be disappear. And the, during the fiscal year, ended September 30th, which is the first year after business combination, the following occurs. On September 1st, the Sprint, which is the subsidiary, declared dividends of 80,000, Sprint, which is the parent company. On 18, they paid the 80,000 dividends to the parent company. On 30th, they reported a net income of 980 for the year to Sprint. And remember, this is what this is overstated. And the goodwill was determined to be unimpaired, which means this goodwill will happen, will be the same. And the required for these problems is to prepare a journal entry for the parent corporation, which is Benz in our case, to record the operating results of the spare company, which is the subsidiary, for the first fiscal year 2017 under the equity method of account. And of course, we'll disregard the income tax. So the solution here is what? To solve this problem, first we have to mention the dividend declared on September 1st. And that's when the parent books will be, as we mentioned before, will be debit in our company dividend receivable, credit investments in its company, which is 80,000. Why? Because this is a wholly owned subsidiary. And on September 18th, the parent received its dividends, which is will be debit cash, credit in our company dividend receivable of 80,000. When the subsidiary mentioned that they have a net income of 980,000, and the parent is this subsidiary is wholly owned, so the parent is supposed to be added this one to his net income. By what? By debiting investments in his company, common stock, credit in our company investments income. So every time the subsidiary make net income, investments in the account, in the record of the parent company will increase. But if it if they have a net loss, of course, we have to reverse the entry. And at the same time, you have to adjust the net income from the subsidiary by what? By the depreciation and the inventory, which is we mentioned before, which is 5 for the first year. So we have to make adjusting entry by reversing this previous entry by debiting in our company investment income credit investments in this company. And this 40,000 came up from what? Inventory of 20,000, which is FIFO, as we mentioned before. And the depreciation plant assets for 10 years will be 12. And the amortization of intangible assets for 5 years will be 8,000. So the total of 40,000, which means what? It means the net income of the subsidiary company is overstated by 40,000. And that's why we have to reverse the entry for this income of the subsidiary by making this adjusting entry in the parent books. Now, if this is the record, so how, what will be the elimination for the first year entry? First, we have to eliminate everything. We have to eliminate the dividends. Why we have to eliminate dividends? Because now the parent company and the subsidiary, now they became a one economic entity, which means what? This parent company, if it was one economic entity, of course, no entity, مش ممكن entity, حتوزع dividend على نفسها. So we have to eliminate these dividends. By what? By decrease the dividend declared in the subsidiary, which is was debited, we have to credit it and debited investments, which means there is no dividends and we have to return this investment back by debiting the investments. And also, we have to eliminate the intercompany investment income. Why? Because the parent will put this one in its income statement. And at the same time, we have to prepare what we call it consolidated income statement. So if they move, if they let, if they did not, if the parent company did not move the inner company investment income from its income statement, that means we'll be double counting. So we have to eliminate the inner company investment income by what? By inner company investment, inner company investments, income credit investments. But remember, this is adjusted inner company income, which is after we consider the depreciation and the amortization, as we mentioned before. Then after that, we can eliminate the investments, which is the usual things. But of course, the common stock and the additional bidding capital, and the retained earnings of the subsidiary company, and also the if we have a land, this will be the land, there is no depreciation for land, so the land will be continue. But the plant assets and the patent will be after depreciation and amortization. And of course, the goodwill, he mentioned this, it was unimpaired, which means there is nothing happening for the goodwill. It will be the same every year. And everything we remove from these differences, it will be either in the cost of goods sold or in the operating expense. We have to mention what would be the policy for the subsidiary. And also we have to credit the investments. If we make this three elimination, so we have, if we remove this one, so we have the beginning balance of the investment. But we can make all these three entry in just one entry, by the way. But it will be better to make a three entry. It will be easier for you, for all of you. So we have to, first, we have to eliminate dividends. We have to eliminate the inner company income, investments income. And also we have to eliminate the investments as usual after we consider all we have did before. Then that's what we mentioned, we can do it in just one entry. If you, but this time, so we have to put the investments, which is the ending balance, not the beginning balance. And remember, every time we have to eliminate the stockholders' equity of the subsidiary company, we have to put the beginning balance of the retained earnings. And also we have to put the plant assets and patent after the depreciation and amortization until the this difference will be finished. So we have this exercise to explain this one. This is was the working paper elimination for the parent company and its wholly owned subsidiary on the date of business combination. As we did in chapter 6, this is the stockholders for the subsidiary, and also we have inventory for FIFO, and they have land, building, and they have goodwill. And of course, this is a wholly owned subsidiary. What happened in the first year? We have additional information for the fiscal year ended May 31st, year 2017. The S company, which is the subsidiary company, had a net income of 80,000 and declared and paid a dividend of 30,000 to Mali, which is their parent company. And the S company uses FIFO for the inventory and the straight line depreciation and amortization for the plant and the intangible assets. And also, the on May 1st, 31st, year 2016, the S building had a remaining economic life of 10 years, and the consolidated goodwill was unimpaired as of May 31st, year 2017. S company usually include depreciation and expense in the cost of goods sold. So we have to put it also in the cost of goods sold in the consolidated income statement. And the required is to prepare a working paper elimination in journal entry format and for Mali Corporation, which is the parent company and its subsidiary on May 31st, year 2017. We can make it in one entry, and also we can make three entries, which will be better for all of you to understand. So first we have to eliminate dividends. Now, by debiting investments, because dividend increases the investment, now we have to return it back. So we have to debit investment in this company, common stock, credit dividend declared by the subsidiary. Second entry, to eliminate the inner company investment income. But remember, to remove the adjusted net income, which is debit income, inner company investments income, credit investments income, which is 80 minus 65,000. 65,000 issues what for the inventory and also for the depreciation of the plant assets. And after that, we can eliminate the investments in each company common stock by debiting the stockholders' equity. And remember, this retained earnings, which will be the beginning balance, because the second year, for example, will be the beginning balance for the second year, and so on. Land, of course, will continue with us, but the building now after the depreciation, which is 5,000, and of course the inventory now disappear, and now it became cost of goods sold. And that's why the cost of goods sold is divided by 60 for inventory and 5,000 for the depreciation of the building. And the investments, once we make these three entries, so now we have go back for the beginning balance of the investments in this company. If we make all the three in just one entry, it should be the final, the ending balance, not the beginning balance. Another exercise for this one, this is also the working paper elimination for Egypt Corporation and its wholly owned subsidiary Algeria company on July 31st, year 2016. The date of business combination was as follows. Usually we start with the elimination entry on the date of business combination, then we can continue. And we have a common stock for Algeria, which is 50,000 within earnings, 150,000, there is no additional investments, which means this common stock with this Algeria company, they have no bar, no stated value. And they have inventory here, which is the difference between the carrying amount and the current fair value of 30,000, and they have a plant assets of 120,000, and of course they have a goodwill of 20,000. This gives you the investments in this company of 470,000. The additional information they have for the fiscal year in the July 31st year 2017, which is the first year, Algeria declares, the subsidiary declares dividends of 20,000 and had a net income of 50,000, for which Egypt applied the equity methods of accounting. Algeria uses 10-year economic life for depreciation for the plant assets, with depreciation expense included in the cost of goods sold. The consolidated goodwill also is unimpaired, was unimpaired on as of July 31st, year 2019. And the requirement is what? To prepare working paper elimination and journal entry format for each corporation and subsidiary. So we have to make what, three entries. One, for the dividends, and the second one for the adjusted income, and the usual for the investments. And this is a solution for this exercise. To eliminate dividends will be with investments in this company common stock, which is Algeria, of course. Dividend declared Algeria 20,000. Then the second entry is to eliminate the inner company investments income, and of course this is adjusted income. So it will be debit inner company investment income, credit investments in this company common stock. Their income was 50,000, but we have depreciation, and also after we eliminate the dividends and the adjusted net income, now of course we have to eliminate the investments in this company common stock, which is the usual elimination entry by debiting the stockholders' equity for the subsidiary company, common stock and return earnings, because there is no par value, no stated value. And also we have to eliminate the plant assets after the depreciation for the first year, which was 12,000. And of course the inventory, we assume that it's already sold, so that means there is no inventory. And the goodwill is still the same because it was unimpaired. And the inventory and the depreciation of the plant assets was debiting for the cost of goods sold, as they mentioned in the exercise, by 42,000. And of course, the investments in this company will be eliminated by the 470,000, which will be the beginning balance. According to the equity methods, the parent company used the equity methods for the result in the following equalities, which is very nice. That's why it is most common methods in the for the consolidated financial statements. The parent company net income will be also equal to the consolidated net income, and also the parent company's retained earnings will be also the consolidated retained earnings. And of course, if we have this one, so the closing entry, we have to differentiate between the retained earnings for the normal transaction of the parent company and from the subsidiary company. So the parent company with the equity method requires a specialized closing entry. Accounting standard require separate account for retained earnings available for dividends to the stockholders, which is equal to adjusted net income of the company minus its dividends. And the closing entry will be net income summary credit retained earnings of the subsidiary company, which is, as we mentioned, which is the difference between the adjusted net income and the dividends received from the subsidiary company, and also the retained earnings for the parent company. Of course, we can make this for the second year. The elimination, we have to consider also the first year, and we can make it in one entry, and of course it will be too large. But we can make it also, as we mentioned before, for three entries. One for the dividends, and one for the adjusted in our company income, and one for the investments. But of course, the investments, which will be eliminated in this case, will be the beginning balance. This was the last things in the first section in this chapter, which is related to the wholly owned subsidiary. Let us break, then we can continue for the partially owned subsidiary. Thank you. For partially owned subsidiary, it will be a little bit difficult because we have to consider the minority interest, as we mentioned before. Accounting for operating results of partially owned subsidiary require the computation of the minority interest in the net income and or the net loss, and also the dividends of the subsidiary. So the subsidiary company prepared the following journal entries for the declaration and the payment of the dividends. That's for the subsidiary company. When they declare the dividends, it will be dividend declared, credit dividends payable, and this is supposed to be for the minority interest. For the parent will be inner company dividends payable, as we mentioned before. When we pay this dividends, will be dividends payable for the minority interest, and the inner company dividends payable for the parent credit cash. That's from for the subsidiary company. Elimination entry for partially owned subsidiary for the first year subsequent to date of business combination will be a little bit difficult, because we have to consider the minority interest either in the dividends or the adjusted net income. So to eliminate dividends will be debit investments in this company, common stock, this is the share for the parent company, and debit also minority interest and credit dividend clears. And also to eliminate the inner company investment income, this is only will be the parent share and the adjusted net income of the subsidiary company, as we mentioned before, will be debit inner company investments income, credit investments, and this company common stock. But we have to consider the minority interest share in the adjusted net income. And that will be debit minority interest in net income of this company, credit minority interest in net assets of this company. When we mention minority interest, we mention minority interest in net assets, but now we have to differentiate between minority interest and net income, which will be as an expense in the consolidated income statement, and the minority interest in the net assets, which will be in the consolidated balance sheet. and also after that we have to eliminate the investments as we did before. It will be debit stockholders equity for this company, and also we have to debit the assets after depreciation. But for land, if we have land, there is no depreciation for land, and also for the goodwill if it was unimpaired, and all these things will be in the cost of goods sold. All the operating expense, and we have to register for investments by the share in the subsidiary company, and also for the minority interest. But remember, this is so it will be the beginning balance. Let us do this exercise. It might help to understand what we mean by that. The working paper elimination usually will start with this one on the date of business combination of the land corporation. Which with the village company business combination was as follows. This is the elimination entry. Usually we started from here, which is the ending of chapter 6. Now remember that once we have minority interest, they mentioned this is the minority interest is 15%, which means the controlling interest for the parent is 85%. For the first the year ended January 31st, year 2018. The village with the subsidiary had a net income of 120,000, and on that date it declared dividends total of 60,000 to be paid in February 28th, year 2018. And the requirement is to to prepare journal entries for the parent company, which is parent corporation, on January 31st, year 2018. Record the operation of the village company under the equity method of accounting, which is the dividends, and also for the net income, and also for the depreciation and amortization to adjust the net income. And they mention here the consolidated goodwill was unimpaired, which means it will be the same. And the second requirement is to prepare the working paper elimination and journal entry format for the parent corporation and also for the its subsidiary on January 31st, year 2018. And they mentioned that the village, which is their subsidiary, include depreciation in the cost of goods sold, not in the operating expense. So this is a solution. First, we have to calculate how much will be the controlling interest for the parent. As we mentioned before, it will be 100% minus the minority interest divided by the net assets of the S company at fair value, and 100 of course. So if we divide the 30,000 divided by 200, we share the net assets, remember, don't take the goodwill. It will be 15%, which means the parent company has 85%. And this is the entry supposed to be in the record of the parent company, dividend or company dividends receivable, credit investments, and the company, which is the subsidiary, has 85% of the dividends, which is 60,000 times 85%, which means 51,000. And also, they have a net income of 120,000 times 85%, will be 102,000. Which means credit investments and the company credit in our company investments income. And we have to make adjustments, which is 15,000 for the inventory and also for the depreciation. So we reverse this entry, will be debit in our company investment income, credit investment in the company by 15,000. But remember, we have to multiply by the parent share in these adjustments by 85%. So we'll have 12,750. And adjusted net income, which will be 120,000 minus inventory of 10,000 and the plant as depreciation of 5, which means we have adjusted net income of 105,000. For the elimination, we have to eliminate the for dividends, which will be debit investment. And remember, we have to consider for the minority interest. So it will be debit investments in the company. Which is the share of the parent company, 51,000, and for the minority interest will be 15%, as we mentioned before, times 60 will be 9,000, dividends will declare will be 6,000. And also we have to eliminate the intercompany dividend investments income of the parent. And remember, this is what this is a term share in the adjusted net income of the subsidiary company, which is 89,250. And also we have to establish minority interest in the subsidiary adjusted net income, which is 120 minus 15,000, as mentioned, times 15%, which would be 15,750, which would be debit minority interest in the net income, credit minority interest in the net assets. Then make the normal adjusting entry for investments, and for the minority it will be debit common stock and retained earnings for the subsidiary company, and the debit for the plant has after depreciation, and it will be the same because it was unimpaired, and the cost of goods sold will be debited by inventory and the depreciation of the plant assets. Credit investments in B company common stock from the current company record, which will be debit, I mean beginning balance, and also the minority interest will be also the beginning balance. To eliminate the investments in the company common stock. How we do it? And we can make it in just this one in one entry. This is a calculation for all this one. As we see, and we have a minority interest in net assets of 20,000, and we have also dividend declared 60, as we mentioned before. This is all of them in one just one entry. For three entries will be better for all of you to understand. Thank you so much for your listening, and I hope you have a good time in learning. And if you have any questions, you have my email, you can send me any questions, I will do it as I can. ودي كانت آخر حاجة في المقرر وآخر دعوانا. أنا الحمد لله رب العالمين وبالله التوفيق، وندعو لكم جميعا بالتوفيق، ونراكم جميعا على خير وفي صحة وسعادة، والسلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.